In this video, we're going to look at what is limiting reactant and what is excess reactant. We're going to use two examples. One is formation of sandwich cookies, and another one is lead sulfide. Let's say we want to make sandwich cookies. To make one sandwich cookie, we need 2 pieces of wafer and 1 piece of filling. If let's say we have 6 pieces of wafer and 2 pieces of filling, how many cookies can we make? For every 2 pieces of wafer and 1 piece of filling, we get 1 cookie. Looks like we still have enough ingredient to make another cookie, so let's combine the 2 wafers and the remaining filling, and that's gonna give us another cookie. So in total, we get 2 cookies. Now we don't have enough ingredient to make another cookie because we ran out of filling. The ingredient that we ran out first, that's called the limiting reactant. In our case, our filling is the limiting reactant. It is used up completely in the recipe. The ingredient that we have left, that's called the excess reactant. In this case, it's the wafers. Excess reactant are the leftovers after the reaction has completed, or after the recipe has completed. If we were to rewrite our sandwich cookie reaction, this is how it'll look like. The reactant that is left over, that's the excess reactant. The one that's used up completely, meaning we don't see it appearing on the product side, that is our limiting reactant. This is an example using sandwich cookies. Now let's look at a chemical reaction, the formation of lead sulfide. We have lead plus sulfur giving us lead sulfide. Let's say if we have the following. 5 grams of lead reacts with 1.5 grams of sulfur, giving us 5.78 grams of lead sulfide and 0.72 grams of sulfur. Now, which reactant is excess reactant? Yep, it's the sulfur, since we have 0.72 grams left over after the reaction. So that makes lead the limiting reactant, because it is used up completely in the reaction. We don't see it appearing on the product side. To sum it up, limiting reactant is used up completely and limits the amount of product form. Excess reactant, on the other hand, is left over because it's not used up completely in the reaction. If you're interested in solving word problem to find the limiting reactant, be sure to check out the next video in the series. I'll place the link in the description box. And also, I have other videos on empirical and molecular formula, percent composition, percent yield, and percent purity. I'll place their links in the description box below as well. Be sure to check them out. Here's a video that I've handpicked for you. Do check out our app that's available in both Google Play and App Store. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you won't miss future videos. Your support means a lot to me.